The truth is, in many countries in the world, there are abductions and kidnapping of children. There is trafficking, and some of that is for very extreme religious reasons. That goes on day in, day out. It's become so commonplace that it gets unreported. This is a moment in time, I believe, in which the international community is coming together and saying enough is enough. The scale of this, I think, is unprecedented, but I think it's attracted the attention because of the perniciousness, frankly, of Boko Haram, some of what they've been saying, and the fact that these girls can be snapped up in this way, magicked away, and assumptions about their life made in such a deliberately pernicious and offensive way. It offends the international community, it offends human dignity. That's why I think we've seen on Twitter, on social media, people of all age groups, all races, saying enough is enough, we need to see action.
The US Secretary of State obviously has now announced that he's going to be offering help, particularly in
international search effort will take intelligence, of course. We've got to understand where these women have been moved to, and it's very likely that different groups of these young women have been moved to different countries. It will take technology, and clearly the United States has that capacity to actually zone in on the area and pick up some of that intelligence. It will take lots of diplomatic efforts in neighboring countries and within Nigeria itself, and it will take some international welly, and that's why it does need more than just the Nigerian government to act.
Mr. Lammy, I think that the British government contributed to this. We saw this coming in the sense that we allowed Nigerian politicians to corruptly bank money into this country. They close their eyes on Nigerian corruption, causing poverty in the northern part of the region, and Boko Haram feeds into this to tap on impoverished children. Can the international community also take blame for what is happening in Nigeria?
It is clear to me that extremism is festered where there is extreme inequality and where there is significant corruption. There remains significant corruption in Nigeria, significant amounts of people totally excluded from participating in what has now become the most booming economy in Africa. And of course, it festers this extremism. So this is not an isolated case. These things happen for a reason. This case has caused the international community to look and act, but it also requires those who believe in human dignity to look a little bit deeper into why we are seeing this happening in countries like Nigeria, in countries like Somalia. Get behind the root causes and don't just act sporadically, act on a day-to-day basis.
Are you concerned about black British kids who now go outside England to get training? They've got some in Syria, and there are a lot of black British Nigerians who probably, are you really concerned that you might have sympathizers to this element in Nigeria?
We're living in an international community where social media has made the world smaller, and where you can sit in your bedroom in the inner city in New York or in London, where you can potentially be seduced by extremism, and where you can save up the money and get on a plane and land in Syria, land in Somalia, land in Nigeria. So in that interconnected world, these events in Boko Haram are not isolated in northern Nigeria. They are inextricably linked to what is happening in the West.
Thank you.
Mr. Lammy, just for LBC, do you think that the international stage should be doing more? Should Britain be doing more to bring back these girls?
Last Saturday, the international community was doing diddly squat. And there were protests in New York, there were protests in Lagos and Abuja, there were protests here in London. Because of those protests, because of social media, because of MPs like myself speaking out because my constituents are raising it with me, we've now got action from the United States and Britain. Will it be sufficient? Well, over the coming days, we must scrutinize whether it's sufficient, and if more is required, we must ask for more, and certainly I will do that.
And finally, what's your message to the Nigerian embassy, to the government?
Well, I think the whole community has felt that the Nigerian government has been slow to act But I think it's true to also recognize that this was never going to be a problem that Nigeria could deal with indeed on its own. There are developed countries in the world that would look for aid and support to deal with this issue. That has now come. We must come together. We must find these girls. We must deal with the root causes. And we must root out this terrible extremism that means that young people can be exploited in this way.
And obviously our hearts go out to the families and friends of the children that have been taken.
As the father of two, my heart bleeds for these families. And as days pass, their weariness, their deep concern for their loved ones, I just can't imagine how that feels.
Kim Tuppe, LTV, coming.